Doc Joseph. Bye, Chef! Sige,
thank
bye.
Thank you po.
May tanong ako. Ang dami mong
morning, Thursday class.
Bagong teacher natin ngayon.
Ako. Yeah. Chef, ako ang teacher nyo.
Yeah.
Ako
na. Si Lito.
Saan na?
Ay, si Lito.
Kailangan mo ba si Lito?
Kailangan mo si Lito?
Sige, doon sa mga.
Kailangan mo.
Sige. Akin na si Lito.
Kaya na yung baby natin.
Okay.
I-disassemble ulit
so,
yan.
So, yung tanong namin.
Mas dito sa row 4 ako. Nakikinig ako dito.
Row 4.
Doc Joseph, ano ang...
Teka lang. Si Doc Joseph to, no? So, dapat nakaharap.
Hematuria.
Spell hematuria.
Hematuria.
Uy. Talagang yun ano eh.
Hematuria.
Ah, okay. Ang hematuria angel kasi is blood in the urine.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, ibig sabihin, dugo sa ihi natin. Mm-hmm. So, ang dapat nating tandaan, lalo na sa ating mga tagapanood at tagapakinig, is paano nangyayari yung hematuria?
What causes hematuria?
What causes hematuria? At kailan tayo kailangan matakot at kailan tayo dapat magpasuri sa isang doktor, no? Now, you have to classify yung hematuria to color and blood clots. Kasi,
yung tatanong ko, Doc, eh. Some people mag-claim na may cancer na ako, so may dugo na ako sa wiwi. Ano yung classifications mo to when you should panic?
Okay. Kasi ang hematuria kasi pwedeng blood tinge. Diba? So, meron hematuria na sinasabi na gross hematuria, nakikita mo. These are really blood coming out of the urine, no?
Mm-hmm.
With clots. Now, even yung blood clots, kailan classified yon? Bakit ibig sabihin classified? Yung may ibang clots natin, yung namumuong dugo, na parang bulate, these are clots coming from the upper tract, no? Pag binuksan natin si Lito, no? Sana naman siya. Di-disassemble natin ang ating... Yung upper tract natin, sinasabi natin, or your upper tract, consists of your kidneys.
Oh my God.
This is it. Operation. Yan.
Oh, sakit. Tinanggal mo ng loob ko.
So, the upper tract consists of your kidneys, the ureter, and partly of your portion of your dome, of your bladder. Ito pala kasi, ano eh, colon yan eh. Andito kasi yung bladder natin, no? So, this is the upper tract.
Yes.
So, when you have blood clots coming out of your urine na parang worm-like or vermiform sinasabi, this could presume na upper tract siya. Ibig sabihin, upper tract ang injury. So, it's your kidney, your ureter, and partly of your bladder. Now, if the clots are coming in...
Sorry, you said kidney or all those other parts?
Ureter.
All of them in combination or any one of them?
Any one of them. Okay.
So, it could be a kidney, underlying kidney disease.
Yes. Okay. So, pag yung clots mo naman, bilog-bilog or globular, di ba, minsan pag umiitay, yun naman, bladder downwards to the urethra. So, bladder, pag sa male, prostate, di ba, then sa urethra, both female and male.
Okay. Bakit iba yung shape ng clots, Doc?
Kasi it configures to the anatomical structure. Kaya worm-like siya kasi, di ba, ureter mo parang
uwi. Kung saan yung dalo
yan. Yes. So, that's one thing that you have to clear off, no? Yung clots, no? Then yung color ng urine, sinasabi ko kanina, we have gross hematuria and microscopic. Microscopic, hindi mo nakikita sa ihi. Pero pag binasa mo yung urinalysis, sasabihin ng doktor, oh, Angel, o yung ano mo, relatives mo, o yung kasambahay mo,
meron
dugo. Sabi mo, eh, Doc, wala naman ako nakikita. Wala naman siya napapansin na may dugo. That's microscopic.
Even sa color, hindi mo masasabi.
No, you cannot trace. These are microscopic.
Uh-huh.
Okay? Why do we classify it microscopic? Ibig sabihin, iba pa rin. Pag gross hematuria, ibig sabihin may active bleeding. It's more acute. Mas nakakatakot. Kasi gross, nakikita mo eh. Kasama yung blood clots, ano. So that would warrant something that an immediate diagnosis.
And then this comes also with pain.
Yeah, it comes with pain.
It comes with pain, no?
So pwede kang painful hematuria or painless hematuria. Usually, ng mga cancers, painless yan. Tends to, for a duration. Pag mga painful hematuria, yun, mga stones, mga kidney stones,
so, kunyari,
prostate
sa,
infection,
sa urine infection. Mismo, Doc. Sa urine, kunyari, sa linagay mo sa floor or sa glass, you will see the trace of it among the clear liquid.
Yes.
What if yung instance, yung blend yung blood sa loob ng urine? So nag-tinge yung buong urine ng color.
Pwede kasi mag-tinge rin yun eh. Do you have to examine it? So when we examine it, we not only look at the color, Diego, but also the pH. No, we just have to check the pH of it. No, kaya pag nagpapa-examine ka ng urine mo, titingnan niya. Dok, parang yung kulay ng ihi ko matingkad. Parang may dugo, di ba? Pero how would you know that is true blood, di ba? We have to check on it. We check on the pH. Kasi sometimes, sabi ko nga, if your diets are strong in siguro protein and other very high, if you intake ang yung mga vitamins mo, whatever you take, yung color ng urine mo magiging matingkad. Oh, and some fruits and ano, yeah, will like give you beets, color. Diba? Beets, di ba?
What's a healthy color?
Clear. Amber.
What about the smell also? Kailangan
it should
no smell.
It should be odorless.
Odorless. In taste.
Oh my gosh. Let's not go there, okay?
Depending on the pH.
Uh-oh. And hematuria, para rin sa kaalaman ng lahat, it both affects female and male.
Yes, it both affects female and male. And of course, the pediatric age group. Mm. Dapat nating isama yung pediatric age group, lalo na kung kasi we have children that have microscopic hematuria due to congenital defects na minsan hindi detect ng mga mothers.
Is it because then, hindi yung iba hindi pa circumcised or not necessarily?
Not necessarily circumcision, but most of them could be anatomical congenital defect that we need to check, especially mga reflux. Mm-hmm. That's why later on they get into problems of the bladder because hindi nila napapa-check yun. Mm-hmm.
Mga ways para ma-prevent natin itong hematuria na to. I'm sure there are stages of this one.
Yeah.
Diba? Yung levels.
Yun. Kung makita mo na may blood clots, that's one. If your color is changing in appearance, mm-hmm. you have it checked. No? Then lagi natin sinasabi, you have to locate where the hematuria is. Diba? Minention natin. The clots are very significant. The color is very mm-hmm. significant if it's cross or microscopic. Now, in case na nasa diagnosis mo, nakita mo to, then you go on evaluating to a more higher levels of diagnostic modality, ultrasound, CT scan, in order to check where is the location.
And
you don't give antibiotic if you have microscopic hematuria. That is the wrong, one of the wrong management of some of our practitioners, especially in the rural areas, wherein they give antibiotics kahit na walang infection. That is where we get a lot of the resistance. Kasi sabi nila, matitreat lang yung hematuria.
Yes, yun yung question ko, Dr. Joseph. Kasi when you're diagnosed na meron kang UTI, is it more likely na magkaroon ka ng hematuria? Because nyari mataas yung protein ng content ng urine.
Depende if your urinary tract infection has caused, is prolonged the duration, yung chronic UTI na. Nakatingin siya, Talia. Matagal na siya, untreated, tapos there is corresponding lining trauma. When you say lining trauma, the epithelium of the urethelium of the tract is traumatized. So you can have persistence of your hematuria.
Ang question ko, di ba kunyari sabi mo kidney, pwede possible. Mm. Why would you be excreting blood from the kidney? What is happening to your kidney at that moment?
The function
moment?
Is going into dysfunction. Yung so function na normal, yeah.
So it will be a sign of kidney failure.
Yeah, kidney failure. Okay.
So, Dr. Joseph, is importante na after mo, kunyari, nagpa-urinalysis ka, di ba? Tapos na-treat na yung, kunyari, akala mo, nawala na yung pain nung pagwiwi mo and stuff. So, akala mo na clear na. Kailangan magpa-check after ng yung kunyari i-take yung antibiotic. Kailangan magpa-urinalysis
yes.
ulit.
Ako kasi Italia,
kasi minsan yung mga Pilipino, yeah. 'di ba, parang after pag wala na yung pain, okay na yan, hindi na papa-check.
Ako kasi after na bigyan kita ng course ng antibiotic for 1 week or 10 days depending on the number of pus cells mo, kasi your course of treatment may go to 7 days or 10 days. Kasi minsan tatanong mo, di ba, Angel, bakit 7 days, bakit 10 days yung isa? Mm-hmm. Depende sa taas ng intensity ng infection mo. Okay, now just in case that you did a repeat urinalysis and the urinalysis is normal, ako kasi what I do, I check for culture. Just to be sure na magiging clear ka. Kasi I have a tendency or notion that your patient, like what you're saying, might not come back because they are okay. Yes. Nangingiti siya, parang okay na ako, wala na ako nararamdaman. Oh. So, ipapa-culture kita. Pag yung culture mo is below 10,000 colonies,
okay na yan, that's safe.
Okay na yan, that's I'm safe. So you can go on with your life.
Pero, kasi nabanggit mo, hindi pwedeng antibiotic. Ano yung treatment?
Ng ano, pag may hematuria. You look for the source. Bakit ka dinudugo? You look for the source.
So wala yung ano ang shockwave, cause? Shockwave therapy yan.
No, the shockwave therapy will come after nakita mo may stone ka.
Pero kaya yung never... eating lifestyle mo ba, nagkaroon din ng cause ng kaya ka nagka-hematuria or simple bacteria infection?
No, pag lifestyle eating will cause, yung hematuria mo will not be detrimental. No, siguro yung color changes. Kaya sabi ko nga, importante, like I telling Diego, the pH is very, very significant. No, if you have a normal pH of 6 to 6.5, if you're going alkaline to 8, anong kinakain mo? It's more basic. Or you're going down to 2, acidic. No, so this could be something else coming from ano, are you talking about the urogenital or the other systems, di ba? So iba pa rin yung ano. Now with regards to, ano ba yung isang question mo?
Yung kung simple bacteria lang siya,
simple bacteria. Pag simple bacteria, you will have sometimes minimal, sabi nga ni Italy, minimal hematuria kasi nasusugatan yung lining. Habang dumadaan, nagkaano yung encrustate yung bacteria, sinusugat niya yung lining. Alam mo yung lining ng urogenital tract is manipis. Manipis yan, parang balat na manipis, ganun. So, pag nasusugatan yan, duduguin ka. That's why, di ba, for men that don't urinate and suddenly you urinate, yung biglaan, di ba, nag-retention pressure, you have blood. Yung biglaan, yung sobrang pigil mo, tapos sometimes you can have blood tinge coming out. Because of that.
Now, I have also questioned Dr. Joseph. Number one, is this treatable? Or once you have it, you have it. It's just management. Tapos, sige, yun muna yung
it's treatable if you, Angel, you have found the source. Mm-mm. Nakita mo na yung source. Importante kasi yung source eh. Never have it give, doctors give antibiotic without knowing the source. Diba sabi ko sa'yo? Kasi we have to find where the source is. Once you find the source, bibigyan mo ng corresponding and definite treatment. Is it stone? Is it mass? Bukol ba yan? Pag bukol, then we go to other avenues of ano, may algorithm siya na ano eh. Now, then you give your proper definitive management. So, it's treatable na.
Tapos yung isang question naman, ano yung pinaka-worst na mangyayari kung hindi mo ito na na address?
Then it gets to the complication na where the source is. Kung bato siya, di magkaroon ka ng infection. Magkaroon ng obstruction, di ba? Kung bukol siya o mass, elsewhere, when we talk about elsewhere, sinasabi natin, from the kidney down to the ureter to the bladder, elsewhere, masa, bukol, then you get, either you get it on a late stage or a metastatic stage. Pag sinabi metastatic, kumalat na siya. So, it is more worse than a simple hematuria. Di ba? Kasi hindi mo nahanap yung source eh. You cannot keep on bombarding antibiotic. Nawala namang, hindi naman. Magbibigay ka ng antibiotic, mag-urinalysis sila. Tumataas ang urinalysis, yung hematuria mo. Namin sa urinalysis mo, nakalagay, too many to count. TNTC, di ba? Punta ka sa doktor mo.
How often should you have yourself check for the urinalysis? Is it kasabay nung physical examination mo?
Yes, it can be. Pero if you have symptoms, di ba, sometimes you have symptoms. Kasi maangot na si Tali. If you have symptoms, you have yourself check. Pa-urinalysis ka. Ang symptoms lang naman kasama nyo, misang balisaw-saw. Diba? Yung parang medyo mahapti. Don't hesitate. Do a urinalysis. Urinalysis is very basic and not too much expense, no?
But, Doc, so, are there outward symptoms, kunyari, that coincide with yung hematuria? For example, you have fever.
Yes.
Headaches.
Muscle pain.
You can have, depending on what is the cause.
So, if it's the kidney.
If you kidney infection, and then you have fever, flank pains, lower pains, and everything.
So, ganun pala yung hematuria, and then they're underlying.
Yes, underlying okay. Yun.
So, first, you have it tested, di ba? Kung yes. Meron nga, then you have to find out yung cause.
Yung cause.
But also, the doctor will ask ko ano yung physical na nararamdaman mo. Because mm-hmm. it will more or less give him an idea yes. kung kidney ba or
exactly,
dito.
Exactly. More or less, matatrack down mo yung location.
Pwede bang sabay-sabay lahat yung nangyari?
Pwede. Oo, wow. Pwede, pwede yun. Ang importante kasi mahalap lang Angel yung saan siya. Saan mm-hmm. siya nagmumula? Bakit ka dinundugo?
Oo.
And the duration.
So, pero nabanggit mo kanina, Doc, ano eh, sa area din ng pediatrics meron din. So, gaano ka bata?
You can go as
early
ano,
as what age?
Infants.
Talaga?
Namamana?
Infant, hindi siya namamana. Because of some the cause. Mother. Isabi ko, one of the causes yung congenital. Analysis, no? Minsan yung mga bata hindi natin na ano, or even hygiene.
Yeah. Ay,
parents who are not, exactly, mm. Yan, tama tali. Yung mga hindi hinugan, nakababad sa ihi, yun, you can.
No? Eh, yung pagpipigil ng wiwi, does it cause hematuria?
Pag severe na ang pagpipigil mo and it becomes a very, very, strong habit for you. Ibig sabihin strong habit. Parang ginagawa mo siyang daily thing. So, mm-hmm. pwede yon. Kasi pagpigil mo, paglabas mo ng ihi, yung pressure effect that is caused by the urine coming out, mas laugh off yung ano, mm-hmm. yung lining ng pantog mo. Manipis, mm-hmm. di ba sabi ko?
Oo.
Your urethelium is very thin. Yun ang pinakamanipis na balat sa ano. Kasi yung integumentary natin mm-hmm. dito, makapal eh.
Mm-hmm.
Makapal ang balat natin dito. Ano lang, parang ano lang natin, di ba? Lagi kong, manipis ang balat mm-hmm. mo. Pero makapal yan.
Makapal
to eh. Kapal that's moops. Why you can kapal. Pero the thinness is the lining of the urogenital. That's mm-hmm. Kaya delicate siya.
Oh, sige, Dong, anything to add bago tayo mag-goodbye sa discussion na to?
About bago tayo magbigay ng exam. Anyway, ang ano ko lang is like, sa ating mga televiewers, pag may hematuria siya, don't miss out, don't overlook it. Magpatingin no, sa specialista o sa doktor, magpa-check. Meron naman tayong mga basic diagnostic dyan, urinalysis, mm-hmm. ultrasound, and CT scan.
And where can they contact you para magkaroon pa sila ng mga iba detalye about mga ganitong klaseng sakit.
Sa clinic ni Kuya.
Every Thursday. Galing. Yun. Tsaka okay. Dito, no? Sa Good Morning, Kuya.
Dito sa Good Morning, Kuya.
Ayan, maraming salamat kay Doc Joseph na lagi natin nakakasama every Thursday. Isang notable urologist.
Notable?
Notable. Oh, ano na?
Ibalik mo na ni Doc Joseph.
Babalik mo na si Lito. Sige. Bye.